It may be quite simple, but now that it's done, I hope you don't mind, I hope you don't mind what I put down in the words. How wonderful life is while you're in the world. I hope you don't mind, I hope you don't mind that I put down in the words. How wonderful life is while you're in the world.
Good evening, everyone. On behalf of Hayden and Carly, welcome and thank you for sharing in their joy during this magnificent moment in their lives. For those of you who do not know me, my name is Tracia Colwell, and I have been granted the privilege of officiating the ceremony today. Both Hayden and Carly have requested that the photographer be the one to capture today's moment, so if you can please secure your cell phones, I greatly appreciate it. Also, not to be alarmed, there will be a drone that will be flying above the ceremony today. So we just focus on the couple and not necessarily on the drone.
If everyone could please rise for the bride speaking. Thank you.
bride away?
Her mother and I. Take good care of her, Hayden. Thank you.
Welcome, family and friends. We are gathered here today to witness and celebrate the marriage of Hayden and Carly.
This is not the beginning of a new relationship, but an acknowledgement of the
next chapter in their lives together. Hayden and Carly have spent
the last 9 years
learning about one another,
facing challenges together,
and growing in their companionship as true life partners.
Today, we would bear witness to what the relationship has become. Today,
they will affirm this bond both formally and publicly. Hayden and Carly will mark this transition as a couple, not only by celebrating
the love between themselves,
but also by celebrating the love between all of us, including the love of their parents, siblings, extended family, and close friends. They would also
like to mention
the souls who are unable to be here with us physically.
The impressions that were left on the lives of who could call you by those
to have
death will continue to be a
source of strength during the new year.
The Art of Marriage by Wilfred A. Peterson. The little things are the big things. It is
never good to all to hold hands.
It is remembering to say I love you at least once a day. It is never going to sleep angry. It is at no time taking the other for granted. The courtship should not end with the honeymoon. It should continue through all the years. It is having a mutual sense of values and common objectives. It is standing together facing the world. It is forming a circle of love that gathers in the whole family. It is doing the things for each other, not in the attitude of duty or sacrifice, but in the spirit of joy. It is
speaking words of appreciation
and demonstrating gratitude in thoughtful ways. It is not expecting the husband to wear a halo or the wife to have wings of an angel. It is not looking for perfection in each other. It is cultivating flexibility, patience, understanding, and a sense of humor. It is having the capacity to forgive and forget. It is giving each other an atmosphere in which each can grow. It is finding room for the things of the spirit. It is a common search for the good and the beautiful. It is establishing a relationship in which the independence is equal, dependence is mutual, and the obligation is reciprocal. It is not only marrying the right partner, it is being the right partner.
Family and friends, we hold marriage as a sacred union between two people who are committed to loving one another and spending the rest of their lives together. Faithful to each other and to the journey that lies ahead. A successful marriage requires deep commitment, faith and trust in your spouse, patience, communication with understanding,
affection,
and compassion. The greatest marriages are built on teamwork, a mutual respect, a healthy dose of admiration, and a never-ending portion of love and grace. I have seen these characteristics in both Hayden and in Carly. I've seen their commitment to one another their confidence, and their conviction. You have a very strong partnership that they have built. But above all, the love these two amazing people
love for one another.
Hayden and Carly, love doesn't always mean that you'll agree, see eye to eye, or never have an argument. It means despite the bad days, you can't imagine yourself without the other. Remembering that you are not perfect, but you are perfect for one another. Understanding this, it's time to declare yourself to one another.
As I guide you in
exchanging your vows, you, Hayden, and you, Carly, will declare your intentions for a lasting partnership in love and in marriage. Are you prepared to do this?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay.
You're already joined hands.
Yes.
Good. Thought Hayden was going to go first. Hayden,
do you
take Caroline to be your lawfully wedded wife from this day forward, to have and to hold in good times
and
in bad, for richer or for poorer, in sickness and in health? Will you love, honor, and cherish her for as long as you both shall live? Caroline, do you take Hayden to be your lawfully wedded husband from this day forward, to have and to hold in good times and in bad, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health? Will you love, honor, and cherish him for as long as you both shall live?
Thank you.
A ring is an unbroken
circle
with ends that have been joined together. This ring represents your
union.
It is a symbol of infinity and of your never-ending love. When you look at these rings throughout your marriage, during the good times and those that will definitely challenge your relationship, be reminded of this moment, your commitment, and the love that you feel for one another. Who has the rings? Hayden and Carly, it's now time to say your vows. Hayden, please repeat after me. Carly, with this ring, I thee wed.
Carly, with this ring, I thee wed.
I promise to love, honor, and cherish you.
I promise to honor, love, and cherish you.
In good times and in bad.
In good times and in bad.
For richer or poorer.
For richer and poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
Until death do us part.
Until death do us part.
Carly, please repeat after me. Hayden, with this ring, I thee wed.
Hayden, with this ring, I thee wed.
I promise to love, honor, and cherish you.
I promise to love, honor, and cherish you.
In good times and in bad.
In good times and in bad.
For richer or poor.
For richer or poor.
In sickness and health.
In sickness and health.
Until death do us part.
Until death.
Wear these rings as a reminder of the vows you have taken today and the commitment to each other. Now that you have joined yourselves in matrimony, may you strive each and every day to meet this commitment with the same love and devotion that you now possess. Give me just a second. By the virtue of the authority vested in me by the state of Kentucky and the Universal Life Church,
I now
pronounce you husband and wife. Hayden, you may kiss the bride.
Oh my God.
You got it.
Bucky.
I am pleased to announce for the first time, Mr. and Mrs. Haas.